Hello everyone, welcome to Abhipedia. This is me, Abhishek Sharma, and today we are discussing one of the very crucial topics in Indian economy that has been initiated by the budget, and it's more of a debate, less of a topic. Can India become a 10% economic growth country? Can we have the nominal growth rate of 10% in India? This is the big question that we have, and it has been raised within the budget. As for the financial year 21, this is the nominal growth rate target that has been given by our finance minister, Nirmala Sitharaman. Now, is it really a possibility for India, and how can government make this target? Because it is not that the government is in any case irresponsible, you know, and it's not that we are into fancies of some kind. But there is some critical accounting which is part and parcel of this targeting. Now, if you see, there are three, four incidents that we have to take into consideration for this to understand how this 10% rate is possible for India. First and foremost, we should know that CSO and NSSO have now been merged, and one institution has been created, that is NSO, National Statistical Office, and this will now be responsible for the national accounting system or the national income accounting as it is. So, with this increased strength to capture the data in a better way, so NSO will be able to gauge the national income accounting in a much more realistic manner, and it will be able to capture it more broadly also. So this will increase your national income. As it is, national income, we talk about it in terms of monetary value of all the final goods and services. So for this purpose, either the produced value should increase or the monetary value should increase. Two things have to be worked about. So we essentially work on the basic three kind of senses for calculating the national income data. One is senses of product method, income method, and the expenditure method, out of which the income method stands out. Okay, but the product method is also important. So for both of them, essentially, very simply, if you need to understand it, to kitni cheeze bani economy ke andar multiplied by kitne paise ki hain. So that will come out to be the national income. Ab agar paison ki baat kare to humari jo national income calculate hoti hai, that is on constant prices. And nominal national income calculate hoti hai on current prices. Theek hai? So this is the real and nominal. Ab jo nominal GDP ka growth rate hai, wo 10% rakha gaya hai, na ki real GDP ka, pehli baat. Dusri baat. नॉमिनल जीडीपी का ग्रोथ रेट जब भी हम बात करेंगे तो प्राइसेस उसको डेफिनेटली इफेक्ट करेंगे, क्योंकि करंट प्राइसेस, ऑनगोइंग प्राइसेस आर इंक्रीजिंग, इन्फ्लेशन इज हाई इन इंडिया, सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट ऑल्सो द ग्रोथ रेट कैन इंक्रीज. डेफिनेटली इट विल गेट अ बूस्ट इफ द अमाउंट ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज प्रोड्यूस्ड आर टू बी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय हायर प्राइस, डेफिनेटली द नेशनल इनकम विल इंक्रीज. सो द सेकंड थिंग दैट वी हैव टू कंसिडर हियर इज दैट द टारगेट गिवन इज फॉर नॉमिनल ग्रोथ रेट एंड नॉट द रियल ग्रोथ रेट. That is as per current prices and not as per the constant prices. Third, within the present year, previous to the 2021, the financial year 2020, in that financial year, we have a lower growth rate. And whenever we see the growth rate from for a particular financial year, we see as per what has happened in the previous year. So it's always an year-on-year based accounting, So how much is the growth in financial year 21 will be checked against how much was the growth in financial year 2020. So accordingly, since in financial year 2020 we had a kind of an economic slowdown or a dip, so compared to that, if you go up in 2021, so definitely from the normal baseline, if it is moving, it will be a bit higher growth rate in nominal terms. So if the economy is going this way a little bit and a little bit up thereafter, so the gap between them will be more as compared to if it was just moving in a straight way and then goes up. Yes? So understand like this. So let's say we are having an average growth rate of 7%, and that's how the economy is moving. So from here, if we have to go 9%, so the gap is critical to the formation of this 9% value. And if it is going like this a bit and then it has to go up, now the gap has become larger, so your growth on the nominal basis will now be larger. This is how the GDP processes are being calculated. One more critical aspect of this 10% nominal growth target is a bit of fiscal stimulus that the government has tried to give in terms of tax incentives, tax reliefs, and certain kind of new tax rationalization policies. So from this perspective also, it will help. Moreover, the fiscal stimulus that has been provided in the budget by deviating from the normal fiscal glide path that was to be 3% this year, but we have increased it by around 0.5%. So this will increase the government expenditure within the economy. And if you remember, within the national income estimates, there is also a part national expenditure, which is C plus G plus I plus X minus M. So as it is, the government expenditure is G. So if the government expenditure is increasing in the economy, that will also take the economy towards the higher growth rates. So essentially, we are working from various angles, and these various angles, the government must have worked out the figure in this manner that there is a possibility of a nominal growth rate of 10% in the GDP. So don't get too much alarmed and baffled when the government says words like this. It is all based upon the statistical aspect. So it is important to understand the nitty-gritties of the statistics so that if in case the question is asked in mains, so you should be able to handle it. So all the best. Thank you so much. This is me, Abhishek Sharma, signing off. Make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get all the latest updates on economic concepts and how do you understand that in the current application scenario. All the best to you. Thank you so much.